before we start with the installation, we need to download the software. Open any browser and go to the Allplan Connect website. The link is provided in the video description. If you have an account, log in. If not, click on Register to Allplan Connect. Fill out the form with all the required fields marked with an asterisk and register your profile. After successfully registering and confirming your registration via email, you can go to the Login tab and enter your details. As a member, you have access to a wide range of content, including the Downloads section. The latest version is displayed first, along with previous versions. Click on Download, and on the next page, you can see some of the basic requirements your computer needs to install Allplan. There are also detailed system requirements that specify the necessary computer performance for optimal software functionality. Additionally, there is a cool feature to test your computer components, giving you a clearer picture. Click on Download again, wait for the download to complete, and locate the installation file on your computer. Double-click to start the installation. A new window may or may not appear depending on whether you have a previous version of Allplan installed. Currently, I have Allplan 2023 installed, so I am presented with three options. First, Update. This option updates all projects, office settings, and other data to the 2024 version, allowing you to continue your work in the new version. Note that this method will remove the previous version of Allplan, replacing it with Allplan 2024. Second, New Installation. Within this option, there are two sub-options. First, New Installation Without Data Transfer. This installs a new, clean version of Allplan without transferring any data. You can manually add settings and projects from older versions later. This option retains previous versions of Allplan and is ideal if you want to start fresh or are installing Allplan for the first time. Second option is New Installation with Settings Transfer, but without Projects Transfer. This installs the new version and transfers settings but not projects, keeping all previous versions of the software. Choose the option that best suits your needs. I will choose a completely new installation and proceed to start setup. Next, accept the license terms after reading them, and click Agree to continue. Now we are at the General tab, but don't forget the Options tab. First, set the main country for your projects. For example, if you're working on the German market, select Germany and choose the language for Allplan. English is commonly used. Below, you can choose the installation location and where your future projects will be saved. The country choice is crucial as it brings specific standards like rebar markings, steel quality, concrete classes, rebar bending, reinforcement overlaps, layer names, and more. If you plan to work for multiple countries, go to the Options tab. Here, you can enable additional countries and languages if needed. Below, there are additional options you can install with Allplan, but they are not necessary for this course. Return to General and click Install. We skipped the waiting part, and once the installation is complete, uncheck the automatic launch of Allplan and click Complete Installation. Three new shortcuts will appear on the desktop: Allplan, AllMenu, and Allplan Bridge. Open AllMenu to set up your license. Go to Utilities and then License Settings. If this part does not open automatically, click on License Activation and enter your product key in the blank field. If you are a student, you received this key directly from Allplan via email, or if you purchased the software, the company from which you bought it should provide it. Upon entering the correct product key, a green check mark will appear, indicating everything is fine. Click Activate License. You need an internet connection for this, and your successfully activated license will appear below. In the license selection, you can see all your activated licenses. This part is more relevant if you have server licenses within a company. If you don't have a license, you can run Allplan as a viewer, but all tools will be locked. Click Close, then close the AllMenu window as we have successfully activated our license. Note that this only needs to be done once for all future uses, and next time you can open Allplan through the main icon. In the next video, we will launch Allplan and continue with further steps.